Hey everyone, you might have noticed that we're in a global pandemic right now, and it seems like people with OCD might be struggling more than they have in the past. But as with a lot of things when it comes to OCD, really it depends. For some people, the pandemic has been very anxiety provoking, and for other people, not so much. As with most things when it comes to OCD, it's complicated. So I wanted to share some of my thoughts about OCD and the pandemic, and what are some tips for how to manage things, and what about treatment with exposure and response prevention? How do we do that? And what about teletherapy? So stay tuned. Lots of people approach me and they ask me about whether and how much COVID-19 has affected OCD or my treatment of OCD. And it really depends on the types of obsessions and compulsions that you have, as far as the extent to which COVID might be affecting you. If you have concerns about contamination from germs and illnesses and spreading contamination around to other people, like that, those concerns about responsibility for keeping other people safe, then it's pretty likely that the pandemic has influenced your OCD symptoms and made things worse for you. Maybe you've taken guidelines to excess and it seems like more is better, right? If 20 seconds of hand washing after you come in from being outside is what's recommended, so maybe 40 seconds seems even better. And the problem with that is that over time, that develops into a ritual, 40 seconds, and then what if that's not enough? Now I should go 60 seconds, and then I should do 2 minutes or 5 minutes. And very quickly, things can spiral out of control. But if your OCD concerns things like unwanted thoughts about violence or sex or morality or not just right OCD, then there's a good chance that the pandemic hasn't really affected you very much at all when it comes to OCD. Another thing that I've noticed playing into OCD is this constant stream of news about COVID. That plays right into fear and uncertainty, which of course is like a major player in OCD. And if there's anything good that's come out of the pandemic, it's that the general public understands more what it's like to have OCD. Think about it. All of these questions that we don't really, it might be impossible to get answers to. Am I carrying the virus? Maybe I'm asymptomatic, and I'm carrying it. Should I go and get tested? These kinds of thoughts and doubts and questions, they seem to be ubiquitous these days for all of us. But of course, if you have OCD, that's really nothing new. So if you have OCD, you're prepared for this. You've been practicing for this. Now, when people with OCD or their loved ones ask me about, some tips and strategies for coping with the whole COVID threat, here's what I tell them. First thing is that we have to be open to uncertainty. We have to, understand that we can never have a guarantee about the kinds of questions that I was just saying. Now, of course, there are things that we can and should do to minimize the risks. It's important to follow the health guidelines that have been, put out by, let's say, the Center for Disease Control, for example. But that still doesn't make the risk zero. Like it or not, there's going to be some level of uncertainty out there that we have to accept if we're going to move on and navigate with our lives. So I recommend also setting a particular routine around health, safety, hygiene, things like that. And that routine should be based around what are the latest, guidelines. Another thing that I tell people is it's just not a good idea to watch too much news. All watching the news does is make you obsess more and more. It makes you think more and more about all the uncertainty that's out there. And if you have OCD, that's the last thing that you need. I think it's okay to disinfect things once a day, maybe in your home, maybe surfaces that you touch a lot, especially if you do go out of the house and then you come back and you touch them. But don't get caught up in taking too much time. And if you stay home all the time and you don't have visitors, there really is no reason to wash stuff. And it's okay to wash your hands for up to 20 seconds if you've been out of the house. Once you get back home, wash your hands. Or before you go to the, after you go to the bathroom, or before you eat, or after you've, blown your nose or coughed into your hand or something like that. But understand that after those 20 seconds, after that recommended washing time, it's still possible that your feelings of uncertainty and anxiety are gonna linger after that. And if you can't or if, I guess if you're having trouble limiting yourself to those guidelines, get someone to help you. Get a support person, partner, spouse, parent to help you out. Let those people work with you to figure out what would be reasonable, you know, measures to take. If you have obsessions about responsibility for harming other people, what if I, you know, mistakenly passed on COVID to someone else? What if I made, you know, someone who was vulnerable sick? OCD is going to take advantage of the COVID situation by giving you those doubts, by really throwing them in your face. And you might have, you know, compulsive urges to either get yourself tested or try to get other people to go get tested. And you certainly want to resist those kinds of urges. And again, you know, if you notice yourself having these obsessions, if you notice yourself kind of succumbing to these kinds of rituals, whether it's excessive cleaning and washing, excessive, you know, checking on people or getting tested, then it's important to check in with, if you have a clinician or if you have a relative or friend who's kind of, you know, helping you out, giving you support. It's important to stay connected with other people. If you're, you know, staying at home and doing the social distancing thing, that's good. That's how it's supposed to be right now. And it's really easy to feel disconnected from other people. And what it's important to do is to maintain those relationships. There are also OCD support networks that are fully on Zoom, that are fully virtual. And the International OCD Foundation, their website, iocdf.org, has plenty of information about that. And I highly recommend going online and checking that out if that's something that you're interested in. Now, what about some things to avoid doing? So the first thing is avoid trying to learn everything under the sun about COVID. That's going to play right into uncertainty. I already talked about how it's important to, you know, go easy on the news, maybe like 10 minutes of news per day. And don't let OCD make decisions for you. It's important to recognize what's OCD versus what is helpful, you know, recommendations. Okay, now what about exposure and response prevention, ERP, right? This is the most effective treatment for OCD. And some people have called for folks to stop doing ERP. And I actually think that's a bad idea. So let me say a little bit about doing exposure. I've continued in my practice, I've continued to do exposure and response prevention with patients. Of course, taking into account the safety recommendations for COVID. My practice is primarily, actually exclusively online right now. I'm working with folks over telehealth, and I'll say more about that in a little bit. But what we do is we make sure that when we're doing exposure, we are following the guidelines recommended by the CDC. And within that framework, exposure and response prevention can work just fine. The norms for hygiene and the norms for what's safe have shifted during these times, but the overall goal of exposure therapy and response prevention, right, to learn new information, to learn safety, those things stay exactly the same. And I really believe that we can do effective exposure and response prevention even during the pandemic. So obviously we have to adjust what kinds of things we're doing for exposure therapy to fall within the latest guidance for how to minimize the risk of COVID. There's no doubt about that. And similarly, the guidance for refraining from rituals, right? So if a person, you know, if you've been out to the grocery store and you're working on reducing your fears of contamination, it is appropriate to do that 20-second wash once you get back home. Then we're back to resisting their urge to wash once you've got that 20-second wash out of the way. I think that's a perfectly reasonable adjustment that I think goes along with the COVID recommendations and also is not a deal breaker when it comes to good ERP. Now, of course, you know, for people whose obsessions and compulsions don't revolve around the fear of contamination, there's no reason why you can't continue to use exposure therapy, you know, in the regular way. If you're concerned about, if you avoid knives, for example, because you have thoughts about stabbing loved ones or something like that, doing exposures to knives and being around loved ones is perfectly fine. Of course, you also want to make sure that you're within the guidelines of social distancing. So that might be something that you do, you practice inside your home with relatives that are, you know, part of your bubble or your pod. It would be hard to do those things in public right now. When you're at home, the risk of getting COVID is extremely, extremely low. And so it's appropriate to do the same exposures that you would ordinarily do in your house. That includes contamination exposures, concerns with, let's say, you know, shoes or laundry or things like that, chemicals. Those can be done in the house, exposure and response prevention, refraining from washing. You know, again, unless someone's gone out of the home, and then you come back and you do your 20-second wash, and then you're back to doing response prevention again after that. Now, before I mentioned that I would get back to teletherapy, he would ask me a year ago, if you had told me a year ago, that for almost a year or more, you're gonna be doing pretty much exclusively exposure and response prevention over teletherapy, I would have had a lot of concerns about that. But the benefits of teletherapy outweigh the limitations. I've worked with so many people, and I've been able to be right inside their house, in the bathroom, touching they're touching the toilet, and I'm watching them. I can be with them when they're going to the store. And that has, I think, supercharged the therapy in a way that I would have never thought to do before. I know some people probably have, but it just wasn't something that I was doing a lot of before the pandemic. Often the office is not the best place to do exposures. Sometimes we can only plan exposures in the office, like for someone who has checking rituals and they're afraid to leave the house without doing elaborate checks of the doors and the stove. Now I can be right there with them in a way that I never have before. So before I wrap this up, just know that if you're anxious about the coronavirus, you're not alone, whether you have OCD or whether you don't. That's just something that lots of people are experiencing. It's the norm right now. So let yourself feel anxious. We need to be open. We need to be willing to have that anxiety. We got to lean into it. There is an elevated degree of risk. We need to be careful, and we need to accept uncertainty still while doing the best we can to protect ourselves and protect others. Thanks a lot for watching. Please be sure to subscribe and click on that like button, and I'll see you soon.